Let's explore ArcGIS Pro in 3D. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel for another tutorial. Before you continue to watch, please take a moment to hit subscribe below if you haven't already done so. So today we continue our ArcGIS Pro series and we'll be exploring 3D in ArcGIS Pro. In my last tutorial, we shared and extracted data from ArcGIS Online within ArcGIS Pro. So you can check that out at the top of this video right now. Anyhow, let's get into today's topic. So as I mentioned, we'll be exploring 3D in ArcGIS Pro. I have a couple tutorials already on getting started with ArcGIS Pro. So if you're not here yet, then you can check out my playlist of ArcGIS Pro tutorials so far at the end of this tutorial or at the top of this video right now. We'll be exploring buildings and utility poles. This is a buildings layer package that I'm going to add to my project in the map view. As you can tell, in the map view, you see in 2D, but in a moment, we'll add a new scene and scene views allows you to see in 3D. So we go to insert to open a new scene. As mentioned, scenes are how you see data in 3D. Once the scene opens, you see the globe. So it kind of reminds us of our globe. So now we add the same buildings layer package as a 3D layer in the scene. We'll drag and drop the layer under the 3D layers. One thing to note is that this feature already has Z values. Some say Z, some say Z. And it is a layer packet. So it is important to know that these buildings were extruded before the layer was packaged. And as you know, layer packages save all the properties for the particular layer, including display properties. So now we will link the views between our 2D map frame and our 3D scene. We will go to view and link views. And I want to center and scale. So basically I would want my view in both my 2D and 3D to update as I pan or zoom in either map. And a quick note, you could also convert existing 2D maps into 3D views. So you don't have to always add a new scene. You could just convert your 2D. When you add your shapefile or feature class as a 3D layer, it will likely float in the air like this, even if it has Z values, unless it's a raster dataset, or in my case, a layer package. But in any case, you can start with exploring the properties for the layer and set your elevation attributes there. You can also ask ArcGIS Pro to extrude your features, whether point, line, or polygon features. And when I say extrude, I mean stretching your 2D shape vertically to create like a 3D object. So for example, you can stretch a point to look like a cylinder or a utility pole in my case. You can stretch a line to look like a wall, or you can stretch polygons to look like real buildings. To do this, we have to first make sure we are in our scene and select the feature in the table of contents that you want to extrude. We go to the Appearance tab up top and in the Extrusion group, and we have to select first its extrusion type and your attribute value, which contains the height of the feature. So that's important to have in your feature, an elevation attribute. As you can see, I still have a couple of buildings floating in the air, which means that something is off with my elevation properties. I need to tell it that my buildings are on the ground. Now we will explore and extrude our utility feature class. So I actually dragged my utility under the 3D layer here, but I really didn't have to, and use the same extrusion process as I did for the buildings. One thing you will notice is that there aren't as many extrusion types for points as there are for polygons, or even for line features. Remember that when you are extruding features, you are highlighting the feature's location in 3D. Since I'm extruding my utility, I'm actually getting a good idea of what they look like. Some of my utility features seems to be a bit too short, which indicates that, again, my elevation setting in my layer is slightly off. So I go in to adjust that, and that is what it looks like. With this information, I can present reports, presentations, I can create map books by putting all this in a layout. EGIS Associates has a really good tutorial on this topic. It's really good, guys, so I'll link it below. I can also create a web scene in ArcGIS Online. There are lots of possibilities here. In upcoming tutorials, look out for simple analysis in ArcGIS Pro, creating your operations dashboard in ArcGIS, some customization of your story map, and much more. As usual, thank you so much for watching, and please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share the tutorial with a friend or a colleague who you believe would benefit from this information. Also, leave a comment down below to let me know how you like the tutorials or if you have any other tutorials that you'd like to see. Thanks again, and see you next time.